The Art Plus Place project for Montessori College was about trying to identify artwork opportunities at a very early stage of the master planning process for the college's new campus. We made a lot of effort when designing this process to make sure that it started to line up and achieve the college's greater vision of creating a green school, being an international showcase for sustainable living. And what makes it unique is that we're actually getting artists to work with students at this very early conceptual stage to identify design themes and artwork opportunities to help make this new college a wonderful place and learning environment. One of the underpinning principles of ecological design that the artists and the architect, myself, are using for the project is that solutions come out of place. So that immediately meant that the artists had a day where they immersed themselves on site and experienced what the site was all about in terms of nature and topography and flora and fauna. The artists then also immersed themselves in the Montessori way of learning and education, and also immersed themselves here in the current campus in working with the children to explore ideas, place qualities, and start to create themes and a vision for the new college.
In this case, working with kids, you know, they're a little bit more, well, I wouldn't say savvy, but it's another sort of word. They're less inhibited. They just speak their mind, and so that the child has that opportunity to actually, you know, imagine and participate in that imagining process. The outpouring from the kids was a lot. It was exciting. They were engaged. It was all those sorts of things. So really, you know, the younger age group gave us a textual, visual and a verbal map of what they see their campus to be and how they engage with the world. The 9 to 12 year olds really gave us how they see their shared expectations or shared experiences within those schools. So with the younger group and the older group, but as a collective themselves. And then the older group actually looked at that they need space and time to themselves as self-reflection, and that would enhance their experience and their learning capacity.
The Art Plus Place strategy will evolve as the school evolves in the new location. It's very much grounded in the Montessori way, that children are our teachers. The place teaches us, and with those two things together, it forms a very strong base for the Art Plus Place strategy for the Montessori school. The most important thing was that the artworks and not only the placement of the artworks but how they evolved over time, they had to encompass all five senses. The artwork has to respond to the students and to the community on not just one level, not just on the visual level, that it has to be more meaningful. The brief is quite rich in that respect. There's also opportunities out in the greater landscape to do more temporary installations that can grow over time and also engage with the natural landscape. So there's this beautiful collaboration, I guess you could say, where not only is it about the artist, it's about the artist coming into the school, contributing to the students, contributing to the landscape and contributing to the whole experience for the community.
Now that we're developing a placemaking guide for the new campus, which will have a development program over 10 years, and we're identifying integrated artwork opportunities within each stage of development, that's going to provide ongoing work for local artists to get involved and start creating the works, the spaces, the places within the landscape, within buildings, to actually fulfill the entire vision. So we're exploring how a green wall, which is a part of infrastructure and treating effluent, can perhaps also be an artwork. How a ramp within a courtyard building does multiple things, not only universal access, but a hydroponic garden, as well as a playscape. So these are just sort of small examples of how we see that artists have a continuing role to actually develop components of infrastructure and components of architecture within the campus.
It actually has to work and function on a multi-layered level to a multi-layered audience. And I think that's really the challenge that any artist is going to have.
It's really about building relationships and the capability of actually integrating creative thinking and art practices in learning curriculum.
Having a beautiful campus that is informed by the students and by the place, those are the key things that the artwork will respond to.
To create that ultimate goal of having natural and built environments which are a resource for learning, which is essentially the vision for art and place. Place teaches us.